Today, while I was reading Romans 1, Paul says, a bondservant of Christ. And so I looked up that word, and what it means is one who has no rights, one who belongs to another. And so I guess I just want to ask you the question, what kind of follower of Jesus are you? Are you a bondservant of Christ, or are you just a casual church attender? Really, a casual church attender, you're probably not a follower of Christ, because Jesus said, if you want to follow me, you have to deny yourself, take up your cross, and follow me. I think it's amazing because, like I said, that word means no right. So it gives you no excuse to not live like Jesus. You have no right to be offended. You have no right to be unforgiving. You have no right to be angry. And you know, that's not something that we really preach, but the whole point of the gospel is you have to put to death the old person that you were and put on the new man who is renewed in knowledge according to the image of him who created you. And so when you become a bondservant, you know, Jesus said, well, Paul said, actually, you are not your own. You've been bought with a price. Now, some of us haven't really heard that as the gospel. We've heard, you know, raise your hand, close your eyes if you want to go to heaven, if you want a better life, if you want that. And so some of you might say, I didn't sign up for this. But actually, the Bible is what you have to go by. So when you get born again, when you become a disciple or a follower of Christ, it isn't just so you could go to heaven one day. It isn't so you could have a better life. Like, yeah, heaven is amazing, and you are going to go to heaven one day. But there's an enduring, in Acts it says that through many sufferings or hardships, we must enter the kingdom of God. But there's also a denying of yourself, you know. There's a forgiving when you don't feel like you should. There's a loving your enemies when they do you wrong. There's a loving people that do you wrong and thinking the best of everyone when no one else will. Simply because Christ is in you and he's the hope of glory. The whole point of Christianity is Christ makes his home in you and then his life radiates out of you so that people can see Jesus, so that they can see the work of God in you, and as it says, that they may see your good works and glorify your Father who is in heaven. So I just want to ask you that question. What kind of follower are you? Are you desiring to be a bondservant of Christ? Because sometimes we don't even have that desire. But the Bible says if you ask, you will receive. And you know, it's his will that you would burn for him in a way that you're so hot, as Revelation says, that you know, you do not become warm, or you know, he says I would either have you hot or cold, but because you are lukewarm. So we don't want to be lukewarm. We want to be fire on, you know, fire on as far as following Jesus. So just want to challenge you with that. Are you a bondservant of Christ? If not, is that your desire? Do you want to be his? Do you want his life to radiate out of you? Do you want his life to show through you, and that other people would see him and become disciples of Christ? Amen. So God bless you. I hope this encourages you and also challenges you, because like I said, we do not have rights as a Christian to be offended, to be unforgiving, to be bitter, to be all these things, because Jesus said, put to death the old man. Amen. God bless you.